The date 21st of December 2012 is on the minds of many as the moment for humanity's awakening approaches. Expectations are high as much has been promised, and there is anxiety that what is to be delivered will not live up to your expectations. Do not worry. What is to be delivered is far beyond any of your expectations. There will be no disappointments as a new age is delivered, bringing with it enormous improvements in the living standards of those who presently live in dire poverty, enabling them to live in the comfort and safety that is the unalienable right of every human being. The constant struggle to pay for food and shelter, and the resultant but unreal sense of security that provides and with which most of you have to contend, will be a thing of the past. The light of God's love is shining brightly upon all of humanity, causing many to stir in their sleep. The first signs of a great awakening are starting to be seen all across the planet as the divine light bathes all in its loving embrace. This massive infusion of love into your hearts is accelerating the essential growth in your awareness of your true spiritual origin, and of the fact that you are divine beings created by God to live with Him in eternal joy. As that realization intensifies, so does your desire and intent to experience that state which is your natural one. Cognizance of your unbreakable connection to your Father is returning, and remnants of memories of that state are encouraging you to explore further so that you can remove or undo the garden hose-like kinks in that connection that have been severely restricting your experience of your Father's love for you. Those kinks are the expressions of individual separated selves that you have been using to relate to one another, the egoy masks you use to interact with others and which, because you have used them for such eons, you have come to believe are the true you. They are but shadows of who you really are. You, each one of you, are vast beings of incredible power and ability. You were created in love by God to experience infinite joy. And to enable you to fulfill that potential, He created you as indestructible beings of immense wonder and beauty, and not as the tiny, inconsequential individuals that you presently imagine yourselves to be. You built the illusion to experience unreality and then made little bodies for yourselves to enable you to explore it. Over time, your memories of your true state faded, and your egoic natures were developed to deal with the environment you had entered into and which had become very threatening and totally real for you. It seemed vast and overpowering, possibly even controlled by distant gods who, despite pretending to be scarcely aware of your existence, nevertheless took great interest in your activities and demanded sacrifices from you to persuade them not to treat you too unkindly by imposing plagues, droughts, floods, in fact an endless array of life-threatening catastrophes upon you. You invented and built this insane illusion, and all that it contains has been the result of your powerful collective intent. While you imagine yourselves to be contained within it, it confirms for you the fact that you are each independent individual beings. But of course you are not and never have been independent, because you are one with each other and with God, and separation from that oneness is impossible. Nevertheless, you have been playing this confusing and frightening game for a long time, and it is very difficult for you to understand, let alone admit to yourselves, that you made it and continue to maintain it by that collective intent. Now, with the divine energy field flooding the collective field of consciousness with your Father's love for you, it is altogether impossible for you to continue in your seemingly drugged and unconscious state of unawareness. Love is permeating each one of you to tease out the negative aspects that encourage you to see yourselves as unworthy of knowing God, and that make you feel fearful and tempt you to continue hiding from the warmth and acceptance His all-encompassing embrace. You are, each and every one of you, beginning to feel that loving embrace, and for some of you it is shocking, for others exhausting, and yet others terrifying, because you are still identifying with the little self that you made and hid within. Those unreal feelings and fears are in the process of being completely dissolved, so that any remaining sense of unacceptability or unworthiness will just dissipate, allowing you to understand your utter and unchanging acceptability in God's eyes, so that you can fearlessly choose to open yourselves fully to Him in complete trust. When you do that, very shortly now, you will awaken, and eternal bliss will be yours. With so very much love, Saul.